In this bit of class, we're going to talk about reading URLs and creating our own URLs. So what is a URL? When we say URL, we're referring to uniform resource locators, and that's just another way to say a formatted address. So sometimes people use the term domain name, web address, URL. Many times they're used interchangeably, and they're just referring to the address that you use to send people to a website. So what comprises a URL? Let's take this basic URL here, google.com. The first bit is HTTP, and that is the transfer protocol. It's not always HTTP. It can be HTTPS, it can be FTP. Sometimes you see file when you're working on your local computer, the file transfer protocol. Well, that file just indicates that you're working on your local machine. Sometimes you see telnet. And if you look to the right, you see Google. That is a second level domain name. And then next to that, to the right, is .com. And that is the top level domain name. And sometimes top level domain names can be .com, .gov, .org, .mil, .net. You may have seen all of the country codes too, so .es for Estonia. There's a number of them out there. They're coming out with new ones all of the time. So when you're thinking about a URL, really what you can break that down into is the protocol, the domain name, and then a path. And the path to the file will be how you direct people to a particular document on a website. So you see here we have a generic site.com and then /path/to/file.html. So we're giving our user the domain name, the second level domain, the top level domain, and then there's a slash. And after that slash, there is a path directory, /a/to directory, /document, file.html. And what we're saying to people is on the server, genericsite.com, there's a folder called path, there's a folder called to, and in that to folder, there's a document titled file.html. And if you click on this URL, you're going to get that document. That's what this URL is saying. Sometimes we don't see this type of URL structure. Sometimes URLs are passing parameters, and the constructions look a little bit different. So if you ever see anything like this, that's what you're looking at. What does this mean for us? When we're working on our web servers, we're going to have to be able to create URLs for documents that we put up on the server so that people can find them and access them. So we need to place our documents in the web root of our web server. The web root is the publicly accessible folder on our web server. So everything that goes in that folder is accessible by anybody on the internet if they have a link. So when we're building our URL, we use our domain name, so genericsite.com. That's the public side of the web root. So we always start with our domain name and then slash, and the folders we're going to send our viewers to get them to the documents they need. So if I had an image, let's say, that I wanted to send somebody to, and the image was of puppies.jpg, what I would do is I would send my user to my domain name, genericsite.com/puppies.jpg. If my users clicked on that link, they would get that image directly. If I happen to have that image in a particular folder called dogs, let's say, in my web root, then I would give them a path that looks like this. genericsite.com/dogs/puppy.jpg.